Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Sarah died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him in glory.
Our gathering song is "Here I Am, Lord," which you can find in your worship aids.
To come forward.
Good morning. Neither Sarah or I like to get up and talk in front of people, let alone read something. So here we go. Sarah, what can I tell you about our beautiful daughter, my baby girl, Sarah Bear? The moment she came into this world, she was a firecracker. She had her own personality and cared for everyone. She'd give you anything if you asked for it, shirt off her back, her last dollar. And she's done it more than one time. If there was someone on the side of the road in need, she would ask me to stop, just to pull over, say hi, give them some food, a drink, some snacks, or a few bucks. Her heart was so big. She loved and cared for everyone like no other. She was committed. She was all in. Sarah was passionate, outspoken, wholehearted, loving, and sassy. Now, I don't know where she got all that from, but Sarah wasn't afraid to speak her mind and tell you what she wanted and how she felt. I'd give anything to hear her be sassy again and ask why. Why can't I have this? Why can't I do that? I want to. Our beautiful daughter was full of life, energy. She was my little mini-me inside. She was definitely her mama outside. Sarah loved animals, especially horses. Funny story, she came home one day and said, "Dad, I saved my money." I said, "Saving your money for what?" She said, "A horse." I said, "A horse? Where are you going to put it?" She said, "In the backyard." And she pointed in the backyard. I said, "Baby, that horse needs a lot more room. Not to mention, you're going to make the neighbors mad." She says, "Well, Dad, please, 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 can I have a horse?" I had to tell her that they're too expensive, take a lot of time, and they need a lot more room than we have. She was so upset for a minute that I had to pop her bubble. She loved animals. You know, one other time, Sarah wanted a rabbit. It was recent. It was probably in the last 4 to 6 months, I guess, maybe. She kept asking me about this rabbit and talking about a rabbit. I said, "How are you going to take care of this rabbit?" I said, "Do you know anything about a rabbit or what they need and so on?" So don't you know, within the next few days, with the help of Google and Amazon, she brought me a 2-page letter on how she was going to take care of this rabbit. How much it cost. She had pros, she had the cons listed, what the cage cost, what the food cost, and stuff like that. That's what I mean by committed. She was all in with it. When Sarah was younger, she liked certain movies like Spirit, Avatar, Soul Surfer. I cannot tell you how many hundreds of times we've watched these movies. But what I can tell you is I'd love to watch them again with her right now. I'd watch everyone until she didn't want to. She wanted to watch these movies all the time, so much that her siblings started to hide them from her. Under the bed, in the couch, behind books. Then she migrated to something else, of course, because she was just bouncing. She bounced everywhere. Sarah may not be on this earth with us right now, but she's in all of our hearts and our minds. As I know she's in yours. Sarah has touched so many people over the years with her selfless acts, kindness, and willingness to help and talk to anybody, a stranger. There was nobody that was a stranger. I love reading all your all's memories and posts on the site, and I encourage you all to continue to do that. Sarah is still with us. She will live on in my heart and my mind until I meet her again. I take some comfort knowing that my baby girl is not in any more pain. She's in heaven with my mom, riding horses, and hanging out with other family members without a worry or a care in the world. I love you, baby girl, until we meet again.
Let us stand, please. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Sarah, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I now invite our first reader to please come forward.
My soul is deprived of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell myself my future is lost. All that I hoped for from the Lord, remembering it over and over, leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as my reason to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They are renewed each morning. So great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. My shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my gently you raise me and heal my weary soul. You lead me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me,
our second reader to please come forward.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We know that when the earthly tent in which we dwell is destroyed, we have a dwelling provided for us by God, a dwelling in the heavens, not made by hands, but to last forever. Therefore, we continue to be confident. We know that while we dwell in the body, we are away from the Lord. We walk by faith, not by sight. I repeat, we are full of confidence and would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. This being so, we make it our aim to please him, whether we are here with him or away from him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each of us may receive recompense, good or bad, according to his life in the body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sarah was a great daughter, sister, and granddaughter. She also loved her St. Albert Parish and school a whole lot. And I've heard so many of you say to me this week, the two words that best describe her are loving and caring. Would you agree with that? And then she was also, as Lee said, she was bright, she was sassy, she was athletic. She loved animals, swimming, basketball, volleyball, just liked hanging out with other people, just like yourselves. As I thought about her and what to say, in many ways, she reminds me of the solitary monarch butterfly that came out of my butterfly habitat this year. And that's why I want to dedicate that beautiful monarch butterfly now to Sarah's family and friends in loving memory of her. Some of you know that I raise monarch butterflies. It's one of my hobbies and one of my passions. Some years I've seen 100 or more break out of their chrysalis at the right time,
But this year there was only one. Only one. So much time, I thought, spent nurturing the soil in the springtime and ensuring that there would be rich nectar, rich wildflowers blooming everywhere just at the right time when they were ready for that first meal. And so much protection. Protection from bugs, and then as they get bigger, from other kinds of large types of bugs and birds as well. So much. But given the gravity of this occasion this morning, I can now see why it was meant that there would only be one monarch taking flight this year. See, it was a special messenger from God to say, God says to you, I am with Sarah, and I am with you this morning. The transformation of the monarch is nothing short of miraculous. But if you raise them, there's two challenges. It's sort of like the horses and rabbits, all the things, you got the responsibilities. There are two challenges that you have to deal with. The first one is they don't live long. They don't live long. A typical lifespan is about 2 to 6 weeks. So you could say in one way, they're here and they're gone. And I've often wondered many times why God created butterflies to live on the earth for such a short time, because they're so beautiful. I don't know why. I've asked, but I don't know why. And I think that unfortunately, answers to many of life's mysteries, they're not neatly packaged for us. It just doesn't come that way. So I suppose what I've learned in life with butterflies and with people as well, we just have to enjoy them while we have them with us. The second thing, and the hardest thing about raising butterflies, is you have to let them go. You have to let them go. Once they break out of that chrysalis, they only need just a couple hours for their wings to open up and their wings to dry, and then they are ready to go. Man, they are fluttering. They are ready to go. And I'll have to be honest with you. It's in moments like those that I know that I have to let them go, but I don't want to let them go. I want them to stay with me. And this is by far the hardest part of giving hope to a butterfly. But that's my role in life, to give a butterfly hope and a chance. And after only a short amount of time, just a matter of hours, you have to let them go and watch them fly off into the distance. But rest be assured, God is with them and God is with you. Now released, where Sarah fluttered off to, so to speak. Well, we find great answers and encouragement in the scriptures, as we've heard here this morning. That's why Jesus spoke to them. He could have given you lots of detailed explanations of why, but what we need right now is to be loved. We need to know that there is love. We need to know that we can believe in hope. We need to know that Jesus truly cares about us. And that's why Jesus was always speaking these words wherever he went, because he loves you and he wanted to comfort you in your time of grief and sorrow, because it's something that we all go through. Let me share with you where she's fluttered off to this morning. Well, for sure, her body lays right there in rest. But as we heard in the passage and in the prayer this morning, it's a time of sleep. It's not a time of end. This is not the end. This is just the beginning of something new and something even greater. You might call it a transformation or a metamorphosis. That's what it is. So Sarah will lie in rest, in peace, her soul going to be with God, her body here with us, until one day, in that great affirmation, God will call her forth and she will be resurrected with a new body. A new body, one, they say, that's just like Jesus's. You know, it has no pain, no hurt. Mine's getting old. I can't see, I can't hear, I got arthritis and many, many other things. going on, but when Jesus comes back and my body is resurrected, it'll be a new body, and there'll be no pain, no more tears, no more sorrow with that, because he has given us life. And when he returns, we will go to be with him and meet him, it says, in the air, and our soul and body will come together as one. Paul says it takes about as quick as it takes to blink your eye. How fast can you do that? That's how quickly he said it'll take. But then we will go off to be with God forever. See, Jesus told us something very important in the gospel reading today. He said, I'm with you. Don't let your heart be troubled. And most importantly, the most important thing that we want is to be with him and to be with our friends and family and loved ones forever. That's what we want in life. That's where peace and comfort and solace lie. It's in those kinds of things. So that's why he was always encouraging us, because in heaven, we're in the real presence of God. Today we experience God in certain ways, but in heaven, it's immediate, they call it. He is right there, and we are right there with him. We are his children. We are the children of God, and he is there with us, loving us, caring about us for all eternity. Another thing I like about heaven is there's no more hospitals, no more nursing homes, no more funeral homes. We need them today. But there's none of that. I think what Lee said yesterday, and you said it also this morning, says it appropriately, no more pain. There's no more pain. There's lots of different kinds of pain. There's physical pain. There's emotional pain that some of us have to endure in this life. But let me assure you, she's been released from all that now. All of that is gone. And she rests and she waits until the Lord comes back. And then she is reunited with loved ones, family, and friends that have gone on before her. She will be with them for an eternity. And one day, given the nature of life, we too shall go to be with her. And we too shall be reunited with her. We'll know her. We'll know exactly who she is, and she'll know exactly who we are. And I have a feeling she will embrace you and welcome us into the annals of heaven with great love. I'd like to leave you with two thoughts for reflection this morning in this challenging time. First of all, in the coming days, draw upon the strength of your family, your parish, and your friends. And here's something good too. What greater tribute could you pay to Sarah this morning than to reach out for help when you're dealing with mental illness? That would bring so much honor to her name. And as one of the past state presidents for the National Alliance for the Mentally Ill, I can tell you this, there's a whole lot of resources out there. There's a lot of help. So honor Sarah by reaching out for help when you need it. She'll be glad you did. The second thing is this. In those times when you miss Sarah, think of what she would say to you. I would think she would say this. Don't be sad for me. Don't be sad for me. I'm with God now. I just get the feeling, given her passion and love for horses, she'll have a lot to tell us about riding horses in the meadowlands of heaven. It'll be so beautiful. She says, don't worry about me. I'm on a horse right now, and I'm having fun. You go on with life, and we'll see each other again. So, little butterfly, now freed from the challenges of being a caterpillar in this life, take flight into the loving arms of God, who loves you, who loves us beyond all measure.
And now let us stand, please. The Lord Jesus is the lover of his people and our only sure hope. Let us ask him now to deepen our faith and sustain us in this time of sorrow.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Sarah, a child of God, that she may be held securely in the Lord's loving embrace now and for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Sarah's family, especially her parents, her siblings, and all the extended family, that they may feel the healing power of Christ in their pain and grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from mental illness or emotional distress, may the healing touch of Jesus bring them comfort and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parents who grieve the death of children, may they be comforted by the love of those around them and in the knowledge that their children dwell with God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, that we may keep our minds and hearts fixed on the kingdom that lasts forever, where we will joyously meet again, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of hope, God of grace, God of comfort, we come to you now in our time of sadness and grief. Hear our prayers and help us to find peace in the knowledge of your loving mercy to all your children, and give us light to guide us out of darkness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Sarah, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation. so that should any stain of sin have clung to her or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns into dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Sarah, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with us with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Albert, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Dearly beloved, you are eternally loved by God. At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Your spirit.
Make sure that everyone here this morning receives some sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Life is change, not ended. Earthly pain transcended. God will gently wipe away the tears from our eyes. Life is change, not ended. Broken bonds now mended. We know that we will rise again, for life is changed. Yes, life is changed, but not ended. Do not let your heart be troubled. Have faith in God who hears your cry. Do not let your heart be troubled. God is our hope. God is our peace. Life is changed, not ended. Earthly pain transcended. God will gently wipe away the tears from our eyes. Life is changed, not ended. Broken bonds now mended. We know that we will rise again, for life is changed. Yes, life is changed, but not ended. Rest in God, all you who labor. God knows our pain, God shares our hurt. Rest in God, all you who labor. God is our shield, God is our strength. Life is changed, not ended. Earthly pain transcended. God will gently wipe away the tears from our eyes. Life is changed, not ended. Broken bonds now mended. We know that we will rise again, for life is changed. Yes, life is changed, but not ended. Even though we walk in darkness, our God is there to show the way. Even though we walk in darkness, God is our guide. God is our way. Life is changed, not ended. Earthly pain transcended. God will gently wipe away the tears from our eyes. Life is changed, not ended. Broken bonds now mended. We know that we will rise again, for life is changed. Yes, life is changed, but not ended. Letting go of every single dream, I lay each one down at your feet. Every moment of my wandering never changes what you see. I've tried to win this war, I confess. My hands are weary, I need your rest. Mighty warrior, king of the fight, no matter what I face, you're by my side. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers as I cry out to you, I will trust, I will trust, I will trust in you. Truth is, you know what tomorrow brings. There's not a day ahead you have not seen. So in all things be my life and breath. I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers as I cry out to you, I will trust, I will trust, I will trust in you. Trust in you. You are my strength and comfort. You are my steady hand. You are my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand. Your ways are always higher. Your plans are always good. There's not a place where I'll go you've not already stood. When you walk through, when you don't give the answers as I cry out to you, I will trust, I will trust, I will trust in you. I will trust in you. I will trust in you.
Let us pray. Lord God, your Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Sarah may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Now, my dear friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Sarah in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Sarah in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn now towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain a little while longer to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and are with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, my dear friends, in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Yes.